वेलकम गाइस, अनदर एक्साइटिंग डे ऑफ क्रिकेट, अनदर एक्साइटिंग डे ऑफ द आईपीएल. द सिक्स्थ मैच ऑफ द आईपीएल टुडे. आई विल बी वेटिंग फॉर द टू गेस्ट टू जॉइन इन. क्रूशियल मैच फॉर बोथ द टीम्स हियर. जस्ट अ सेकंड, आई विल ऐड द टू गेस्ट्स. Getting in good comments out here. Yes, we have Jayendra with us. Just waiting for Mithilesh now. Yeah, so as I said, another exciting day of cricket, another exciting day of the IPL, sixth match here, and I've been joined by Jayendra, who is the Sunrisers supporter here, and after the first match defeat against the Kolkata Knight Riders, he'll be surely looking for a victory today. So what are your thoughts, Jayendra?
Yeah, obviously we are looking forward for this match to come back very strongly. We had a very poor defeat.
Yeah.
So yeah, we are hoping to come back strongly.
Well, yeah, I'm waiting for Mithilesh now, who's the RCB captain. As I say his name, I was just waiting. Here you are. So welcome, Mithilesh, yes, to this show. And Mithilesh is a RCB fan, big fan of Virat Kohli personally as well. So welcome on the show.
Thank you. Hello, Vansh.
Hi. So before we start with the previous match performance for both the teams, I would like to just bring out a normal stat in front of you all. 18 matches played between the two of you. 10 matches have been won by the Sunrisers. One was washed out and 7 have been won by the RCB. So it seems like Sunrisers slightly have the edge over the RCB. What do you think, Jayendra?
Yeah, both the teams are so strong. From the start of the IPL, both are the strongest teams. So I'm really looking forward to this match. And yeah, if you're talking about the previous year's stats, then Sunrisers is little ahead in the winning column. So we would like to increase that 10 to 11.
Yeah. And what do you think about the record, Mithilesh?
See, the head-to-head comparisons are odious. But let me tell you one thing, that a margin of 10 and 7 is not a big margin. So definitely, I think that RCB will look to deficit this margin and go on 10-8 after this match.
Well, certainly you're hoping for the best, and so are all the RCB fans today. They had a wonderful start to the season, obviously. And I'd just like to talk a bit about the previous match that RCB played in Mumbai. Mumbai is not a tough team. Mumbai is not an easy side. Very tough team to defeat. So, your thoughts on the first game that RCB played?
I think there was a lot of positive from the first game, if you look into. Firstly, there are bowling lineup. And the return of Maxwell, I can say after 2 years, he had able to hit the six. That was one of the biggest positive for us. And secondly, our bowling. But overall, you need to say that Mumbai is not an easy team to beat. And we saw that during the first game, that we just won by just one runs. So it was a tough, but yeah, we kept believing us and the boys done really a good job. All thanks to the ABD, who came as a savior and just take us and won the game for us.
Well, yeah, as you said, they won it on the last ball of the match. But then again, 2 points in the back for RCB. So they'll be quite happy with that. Similar question to Jayendra. Tough defeat against the Kolkata Knight Riders. How do you wish to bounce back here?
Yeah, the game against Kolkata Knight Riders, we lacked in every department. Our seamers didn't work properly. Our openers failed to do our good start. And the middle order is little bit inexperienced and uncapped. So, I'll expect that they will come back strongly. And you see that game is we are one of the best strongest seamers side, but our seamers were out of form that day. They are lacking in every position. So yeah, I will really want that they will improve today. So I'm looking forward to this and for confidence and the 2 points, that is the big equation.
Well, yeah, certainly. And as I read out some of the comments here, Jayendra is getting a lot of praise along with Mithilesh and his smile, obviously. So a lot of praise thrown out by the fans here. Sanchit has commented that it is the South Indian Derby. So a lot is at stake for both the teams here. A lot of pride and a lot of respect is at stake here. So we should expect nothing but a blockbuster today. Superstars in both the teams. Let me just talk about the opening pairs that both teams have. So start with Sunrisers. Besto, should he move up the order? Because we've seen that the middle order is a bit inexperienced and unstable. So do you think Besto will be a good option instead of Saha, who struggled last night against Kolkata?
No, I think Besto is a stable player. So I think we need Besto in middle order to move ahead the innings from the crucial overs in the middle.
Yeah.
So I think Saha is a good option with just one match. So I can't compare him to. I don't see that he should be move up to the order or go down the order. I think Saha will rise to the occasion. So I think Besto should play in the middle order, and Saha should start with alongside with Warner.
Well, yeah. So Jayendra obviously backing Riddhiman Saha and David Warner on top of the order. But a similar question to you. You've got Devdutt Padikkal now, Mithilesh. And do you think he'll be playing this match? Because the officials have told us that he's fit to play today. Do you see him replacing Washington Sundar at the top of the order along with Kohli?
Yeah, indeed. I think after testing positive for the COVID and missing out the first match, I think Padikkal will back into the side as an opener because he was the highest run getter in the previous IPL for us. Yeah. And an inclusion of Devdutt Padikkal gives a bit of strength to our batting line. Lineup. So top of the order is as good as anyone, considering the youngsters in our team. And we saw his stats, performance in Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy as well as in Vijay Hazare Trophy. They were incredible. So I think he will be coming back as an opener for us. Yeah, definitely.
Well, certainly he had an amazing season last time around, Padikkal, and a lot of fans here commenting about Devdutt Padikkal. Just for our viewers to know, you can put in your toss predictions, you can put in your score predictions, you can put in your thoughts, your questions, anything you want, and we'll take that forward to our experts. So please do keep those comments coming. Coming back to RCB now. AB de Villiers, we saw him struggle. I mean, not him struggle, but generally the middle order struggle for RCB. ABD, it seemed that AB was, carrying the whole team on his shoulders in the middle orders especially. So, do you think the inclusion of Glenn Maxwell and especially Dan Christian back into the RCB camp is going to help AB's confidence and, take the pressure off him?
Yeah, definitely. See, talking about ABD Villiers, we all know how matured and how responsible he is as a batsman. And he's one of the biggest assets that RCB has ever had. So, talking about middle order, inclusion of Maxwell gives us a lot of strength in the middle order. And as you know, during the last match, the management thought of making him play at number 4 because they wanted him to. They wanted that he should get some time in the middle. So, and obviously, you saw he was in great touch during last match, scoring 39 at a good pace, and then ABD coming after that. The reason I think about the fearless game for Maxwell is that the AB after AB de Villiers coming after him, because he knows after me there is AB de Villiers who can carry the game forward and win the match for us. So he knows his role very well and he plays fearlessly and he's like a floater for us. He can bowl for us 1 or 2 overs, he can give us a bit of balance for us, and Yeah, no, we know the what caliber he has, and he can turn the table around.
Well, exactly. One of the stars of world cricket, and India certainly loves AB de Villiers and also Glenn Maxwell now, because he's a part of the RCB camp. And as soon as you get into the RCB camp, popular to bani jaate ho tum. So, similar question to you again, Jayendra. Your middle order is again a bit inexperienced. If you talk about the overseas cap players, you don't have many there except Bairstow. So after Bairstow and Manish Pandey, there doesn't seem to be, you know, some hope for the Sunrisers, because we've seen Abdul Samad play well, we've seen Vijay Shankar play well, but do you think they'll be able to meet their expectations, meet the management's expectations?
Yes, certainly. I think they will improve today. First of all, about Manish Pandey, he played a brilliant inning in the first match. He's consistently playing from over the years. He's one of our best batsmen. And Manish Pandey is our not last hope. Abdul Samad showed that potential to complete the game. So he can hit big sixes. He is the youngster who hit first ball to Pat Cummins, Norte, and Rabada, as well as Russell. He hit six on the first ball. So yeah, he is a great talent we have, and he can finish the game very well. So I don't think so that we don't have an experienced middle order like RCB. Like you said, there is Glenn Maxwell, AB de Villiers, and Dan Christian. But we can finish the game very well. Although Vijay Shankar and Mohammad Nabi cannot bat that well, they are struggling with the timing. But it's not, we are out of the, we have a lack in middle order, but just we need to improve in some stages to talk about middle order.
Well, if you see the comment section, Rahul is commenting that Kohli and Patel masterclass incoming. A lot of comments for King Kohli out here. Obviously, they are one of the popular sides in this year's IPL. And not only this year, I feel that from the first season itself, they had the likes of Rahul Dravid, Anil Kumble, and now obviously they do have Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers. So I'll take a question from the viewers. This question is from Omkar, and he's asking if ABD should come up the order if RCB are batting first, because of the explosive style of batting he has and strike rate, of course.
Yeah, definitely. If RCB will be batting first, then ABD Williams should definitely come up the order, because he's such an experienced player and he knows where to target the bowlers and which bowlers to be targeted, especially. So wo sahi se ek balance create kar sakta hai. Yes. Middle order, man, we are looking up for it, and I definitely in the favor that if RCB will be batting first, then ABD Villiers should come up the order and take the guard for us.
Well, Parth Athalye is saying that I'll support us for Jay today, so good fan base out there, Jay. And Sumedh is asking another question, and I'd like to ask this question to you, Jayendra. Should SRH start with three spinners today?
Actually saying no, because SRH don't have an Indian good spinner.
Yes.
They can have two spinners from Afghanistan.
Mm-hmm.
So if they want to include Mujibur Rahman, they have to exclude either Bairstow or only Bairstow, because they don't have a good Indian spinner. So I don't think so that Bairstow is a good option.
Shehbaz Nadeem is an Indian spinner that SRH have, and do you think he has the experience?
Yeah, he has the experience, but you see, he's a left-arm spinner, and I don't feel that it's a spinner, slow spin pitch. So yeah. Shehbaz Nadeem, I don't feel that he will bowl the way the fans and SRH team want. So I will back up for the three seamers and two spins that we are going with, that we were in the first match.
Well, we've got 2 minutes left for the toss, and I think I'm not quite sure about the conditions in Chepauk, but it's certainly raining cats and dogs here in Pune, so we'll have to look forward to that. But prediction time, and if you win the toss, Mithilesh, starting with you, what would you do?
I think definitely RCB will be opted to bat first, because looking at the condition, and there were the cloudy conditions today. There was a bit of rain drizzle in the Chennai, so I don't think they will be play a huge factor. And apparently, looking at the past few games, chaining was a bit difficult for the team. And Dew doesn't play any kind of major role. So, looking at the condition, I think the team that winning the toss will bat first.
Jayendra, what about you? Do you think that the side winning the toss will bat first, or do you think they'll still prefer the safer option in
the top? Yeah, I think they should bat first. If we want to toss, we should bat first, because in the last four games we saw the teams who are chasing are not winning. The one who are defending is the last to stand. So I think we should bat first and defend the score.
Yeah. Well, certainly interesting predictions from both our experts here. Seeing the pitch last night, and what do you reckon about the pitch? We saw yesterday how Krunal Pandya and Rahul Chahar exploited the pitch and, you know, got turn out of it. Especially Rahul Chahar, he got those leggies in, also the occasional wrong guns. So, what do you reckon about the pitch?
I think the pitch started to be at a lower side. It started being something low, and the knuckle ball or the slower ball will play the crucial role for the bowlers, and they will focus on bowling, bringing out the variations of them. And for the spinners, it will be the helpful pitch. That's it. And leg spinner will get a lots of assists from the pitch.
Same thoughts that Sandeep Sharma is a good bowler, and he has various variations, like he can bowl cutters and slow balls. Like Mithilesh said, the pitch is going slow, so it would benefit him. And Rashid Khan, of course, he is brilliant brilliant in the first match. So yeah, the leggies and the slow balls are very crucial.
Well, certainly. And Hazik in the comment section is saying Champions League cup prediction though. There's a long way to go for that, but before that, we have the IPL now, so we'll put our thoughts on that. The news from the centre is that Sunrisers have won the toss, elected to bowl first. So, certainly they are preferring the chasing option. They've got the likes of Bairstow. They've got... So, another news coming in is that Holder is in and Nabi's out. So, I was just going to mention they've got the likes of Nabi. But,
Nabi.
Yeah, they've got Jason Holder today. So, your thoughts on that change, Jayendra?
Yeah, I feel that they are playing now with two spinners, that is Shahbaz Nadeem. He is in for Sandeep Sharma. Sandeep Sharma, who bowled out Virat Kohli 7 times, is not playing today. It is surprising for me. But Jason Holder is also kind of shocking, because this is a spinner pitch, and Mohammad Nabi bowled very well in the first match against KKR. He took two wickets like Morgan and Russell. So I think he should get one chance, but now he's not in the 11. So let's see how it goes.
Well, SRH are bowling first. We are still not quite sure about the changes that have been made, but let me get back to Mithilesh here. You guys will be batting first today. So what are your thoughts on that? A big score on the cards?
Yeah, definitely. but just looking at the pitch, I think 160-170 will be the odd total. And it will be a real difficult to chase it down, as far as the rain is away from the game. Yeah. I don't think that rain will be the factor coming to the game. But yeah, 170 will be the good score to defend. And looking at the pitch condition,
Yeah, we saw that yesterday as well. Rahul Chahar got a lot of his deliveries to turn, and 152 was defended last year. An interesting match that we had last night, and also that we are expecting another thriller out here, because the IPL sort of surprises. One question to Chandra now, Manish Pandey and his form. So in the last match we saw him getting a 50, but then his strike rate was not as expected, and it was not as what the situation demanded. So, what are your thoughts on Manish Pandey and Striker? Should he go for those big sixes, especially against the spinners, because he is a good player of spin?
Yeah, he's a brilliant player against spin. He's a consistent player, as I said, long time. And if you're talking about spinner, agar mil raha hai to kyun nahi marna? Mil raha ball to loose ball hai to kyun nahi marna? Well, so, yeah, that is the factor in that that his strike rate was so low at that match. So I think he should gear up according to the demand, according to the scoreboard and the situation. So I think he will improve today and he will certainly try to blast out there when he is chasing. Let's see.
Well, and we're getting the news that Sandeep Sharma is out and Shehbaz Nadeem is in as well. Couple of changes, if I'm not wrong. Can someone please correct me if I'm wrong here in the comment section? But news coming in is that Sandeep Sharma is also out and he will be replaced by Shehbaz Nadeem. So, a big spin factor here. Thoughts on that? You already mentioned that Virat Kohli has been dismissed 7 times by Sandeep Sharma. And because Kohli will be batting at the top of the order along with Padikkal today, so it will be a key battle, but we won't be able to witness that today.
Yeah. Sandeep Sharma is out and Shehbaz Nadeem is in. I'm actually surprised that why Warner put Sandeep Sharma on the bench. Actually, we all know how he is a great player. And he got Virat Kohli 7 times. That's not a small number. Taking out Virat Kohli, player like a champion player like Virat Kohli, it's not a small thing. So, I'm a little surprised, but I think Warner is thinking that one left-arm spinner and one right-arm spinner is a good, why not to try? So, yeah, let's see how it goes and I believe that it will work.
Well, and coming to Mithilesh, a few changes here. As expected, Devdutt Padikkal is back on top of the order. Good signs for you, but Rajat Palikar is also out. And in place of him, you have Shehbaz Ahmed today. So, what are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, definitely. I think I know that Rajat Patidar ko bita denge. But because keeping the spin factor and the Chennai pitch into the mind, I think they've gone with a three spinner. Washington will be the... I think Washington should bowl in the first, in power play because David Warner is a left-hander and we know how he struggles against the off-spinner in the start of the inning. So, and looking at that, batting lineup, there are many of the right-handers. So, Shehbaz Nadeem will be the key. Shehbaz Ahmed will be the key for them.
Shehbaz, both the Shehbaz is playing today and Ahmed is batting at 3 now. So, we certainly assume that AB, Dan Christian and Glenn Maxwell, the experienced middle order, your middle order is absolutely looking perfect. So, any changes or any thoughts on that?
No, I think the batting lineup is properly balanced. Let's see how the management decide and how the player will come and bat. I think AB de Villiers should bat top the order, but it's at the end it's Virat Kohli and we don't know how he changes the batting order. So let's see. But I'm hoping that AB de Villiers will come at number 4 and anchor the inning very well.
Yes, enough of batting now. Let's come back to the bowling because this is looking to be a bowling pitch today, especially a spinner's pitch today. And Jayendra, I'll start with you. You've got Rashid Khan, who is arguably the best T20 bowler at the moment, the best T20 spinner at the moment, if you would like me to correct there. But Rashid Khan, Mohammad Nabi out, obviously, but Shehbaz Nadeem and Rashid Khan, what do you make out of this duo? One left-hand, one left-arm spinner, and Rashid Khan, who has the fast action.
Yeah, I think it will help us a lot, but because of the spinning pitch, ek left hand se ja raha hai, ek right hand se ja raha hai, ye to benefit karega hi. I'm sure, we're pretty sure about that. It's a slow pitch and as you said, Rashid Khan's fast, quick air action and Shehbaz Nadeem's arm ball are very crucial for us. I'm sure that Rashid Khan will help us in the RCB's middle order. He will handle RCB's middle order very well.
Yeah.
Taking important crucial wickets of Glenn Maxwell and AB de Villiers is key for us. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to this new duo.
Yes, well, if you are looking forward for Rashid Khan to perform, Mithilesh is looking forward to Chahal, and this is an interesting choice, but an interesting question that I'm about to ask. But Mithilesh, what do you think? Who will have a better season? We've seen Chahal and Rashid Khan bowl exceptionally well in the IPL over the years, but both have different styles of bowling, although they are leg spinners. You've seen Chahal, you know, flight the delivery, beat the batsman in the air, especially be lethal with his googlies as well. So, who do you think will have a better IPL season?
I think definitely Chahal. But talking that a comparison are odious, and we can't compare both the spinners because both have different varieties and both are exceptionally playing well. Both played at an international level. See, फरक इतना है कि हम test playing nation के सामने खेलते हैं. But that's a different thing. But coming to the point, yes, Chahal is a definitely good bowler. We know last couple of seasons he's not doing very well in international cricket. But yeah, looking at the last IPL of 2020. He has an economy of 7, and that's a great sign if your economy is 7 in the whole tournament, playing 15 matches and picking up 21 wickets. So it was a one match, one bad day. You can't say that he's out of form, and we are expecting today that he will play the huge role because the pitch is assisting them. And yesterday we saw Rahul Chahar, how well exceptionally he bowled. Yeah. And I think Chahal will come out of his bad phase and deliver the best of he can.
Well, yeah, certainly you've also got the option in Washington Sundar with the offies, and obviously Glenn Maxwell if he can pitch in with a couple of overs. Yeah. But talking about your fast bowling again, Mithilesh, Kyle Jamieson looking quite good, and obviously you have Dan Christian in the all-rounders package that you've bought. And, he can come in and pitch in with a two-over spell or something like that. But Mohammad Siraj as well, the Indian bowler who is experienced now after playing in Australia. So, Jamieson looking good with the new ball?
Ah, yeah, definitely, yes. Jamieson is looking definitely good at opening the bowling. He's just at the variation. He can go slow ball and start off the inning. As we saw during the last match that RCB played, he was getting some of the swing. So definitely yes, that he can start the bowling in power play and get some help from the pitch. And talking about other bowlers, that Mohammad Siraj was he didn't get wicket, but the economy rate and with the and kind of control he bowled was exceptional and incredible. And one can't forget Harshal Patel, that getting the fifer against the Mumbai Indians, and I think he was the first bowler who took the fifer against Mumbai Indians. And and talking about him, I think the first two over he bowled, he went for 22 runs all. Then coming back and taking fifer bowling in death overs and just conceding 7 runs and taking 4 wickets is a huge thing. So I think he will deliver same performance जैसे उसने लास्ट मैच में दिया. सो वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट आवर बॉलर्स विल डू द सेम जॉब एज दे डिड ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट मैच एंड डिफेंड द टोटल अगेंस्ट एसआरएच.
या वेल, प्रीटी ऑप्टिमिस्टिक आउट देयर, एंड वी हैव गॉट अराउंड 4 मिनट्स लेफ्ट बिफोर वी एंड दिस लाइव. बट देन बिफोर दैट, वन क्वेश्चन टू यू बिफोर वी टेक इन द स्कोर प्रेडिक्शंस एज वेल. जयेंद्र, आईड लाइक टू आस्क यू दिस क्वेश्चन. नटराजन, भुवनेश्वर एंड संदीप वर अ ग्रेट trio. We obviously know the record Sandeep Sharma has. He has the most wickets against RCB when SR have played them. They are also good at defending totals. But then today you've got Holder, who's not at all a bad option as well. He can bowl with the, he can bowl in the death overs as well as with the new ball. So your thoughts on the fast bowling attack? How will the approach be from David Warner?
The fast bowling attack is very good. Still, I think there we need Sandeep Sharma, because I told you that his cutters and slow balls are very crucial. He bowled out Virat Kohli, the main man of RCB, for 7 times. That's not a small number. But yeah, if you talk about Jason Holder, he is an excellent, incredible player. He can bat also in the death overs and can hit big sixes and fours. And he can bowl as well. So yeah, he and Jason Holder is a height has a height person, so he can give the bounce and can bowl a bouncers and short balls pretty well. So yeah, and Bhuvaneshwar Kumar, we all know that how good he is he, with the new ball, the in swing, out swing, and Natarajan with his death overs bowling, bowling consistent Yorkers. So yeah, I'm really really looking forward to this, that the new team, the new two changes should work for us and we'll get the win. Let's see.
Well, Mithilesh would be quite happy that Sandeep Sharma isn't playing because it's the key man, the captain who's at stake there. But let me quickly come across to both of you for the score predictions. What do you think we'll be able to post?
I think 170, 180 will be the good score to defend on this pitch. And I hope the total effort from our batsman will take us to 180. And I'm hoping that Virat Kohli complete his 6,000 runs in IPL. So he's just 89 runs far away from completing 6,000 runs. And again, we are waiting for the masterclass from AB de Villiers. So yes, 180 will be the good score.
Are you confident about chasing 180, Jayendra?
No. I think our bowlers will stop RCB at 150, 160. And yeah, 150, 160 is a pretty good score to chase. So I'm really looking forward to how Jason Holder ball, Bhuvaneshwar, Natarajan, of course, Rashid Khan. So I think the bowling attack we have, we will restrict them at 150, 160 so we can chase the score.
Yeah. Well, we've got a big match on our hands here, and the South Indian derby especially. And I think we are out of time now. The 10 minutes to go for the big game, and we are going to witness the battle between Virat Kohli and David Warner, the two aggressive captains. So we do expect a heated contest and a bit of chit chat as well. So let's see how things go today. Thank you all for joining us in the comment section. You all have been pretty good. I can see Cavalier telling that RCB will win today. A lot of RCB supporters, as I said, but there are no shortage of fans for Sunrisers as well. So we hope for a blockbuster today. And thanks for coming, guys. You were a great company. And
thank you.
Do join us the post-match
thank
as well.
Yeah.
Thank you. Bye-bye, guys.
Bye-bye.